Happy Friday, SD192. Mr. Berg back with our weekly distance learning update. This also happens to be the last distance learning update as well. It's been quite the roller coaster ride over the last 2 months, but it's still hard to believe that we are now entering our last week of school. Been a really, really busy week this week across the district. A lot of picking up and dropping off materials at all of our sites. I know that there's probably families that weren't able to get to buildings, maybe to get some student materials that were left there or to drop something off. If you missed any of those pickup or drop off times or days, feel free to just reach out directly to your building's office and they will help you figure out a time when you can come in and either collect what you need to collect or drop off what you need to drop off. This was also a big week at FHS in terms of some year-end celebrations. Like a lot of things we're doing, unfortunately, they have to be virtual. The cool thing about the virtual events is if you did miss them, you can always go back and watch them. Tuesday night was the spring virtual band concert and kind of the senior send-off. Super, super cool to kind of see the video that the band department put together to celebrate their seniors. Wednesday night was the senior awards banquet. Always a cool opportunity to see our greater Farmington area public schools community come together and support our students that are going off to post-secondary institutions and see the amount of money that our students receive in scholarships. And the other cool thing about that event is it was half live and half virtual. Mr. Pickens was live and the other parts were virtual and the stuff meshed pretty well together. Last night on Thursday night was the spring choir concert and senior send-off. And again, like the band concert, it is so cool to see the compilation of things that they put together and then the senior slides that they put together as well as a send-off. It's kind of fun to see those baby pictures and the other things that go into those two things. It's always fun to try to guess which student is which, and then you see their older picture and away it goes. Tonight is one of my favorite nights when it comes to our senior send-off things. It's a Distinguished Scholar Banquet. And again, that is going to be virtual. And so if you're interested in tuning into that, that will be streamed live as well. If you're looking for any of those links, you can go to the Farmington High School homepage. And it's a news article right there with all those links in there. So if you missed any of them or interested to see what any of those are, feel free to hop onto that page and you can go back and watch it at your leisure. Next week is another big week across the district. A lot of celebrations, whether those are grade level or classroom type celebrations or building celebrations. It's fun to see that even though we can't come face to face, that we can still figure out ways for our buildings and our learning communities to celebrate in a socially distanced and responsible manner. So it'll be fun to be able to watch those and be part of those as they take place next week. And then probably the biggest celebration we have is next Friday is our senior graduation. We understand that based on the guidance, that a lot of disappointment around the fact that we were not able to do a face-to-face graduation ceremony. But Mr. Pickens and all the high school teachers have worked really, really hard over the last couple of weeks to put together a virtual graduation ceremony that is as close to a real graduation ceremony as we can get. So that will be streamed live right off of the district YouTube channel next Friday night at 6 o'clock. And as a precursor to that, our high school staff are going out on Thursday, June 4th, and they're gonna hand deliver to each student their diploma, their cap and gown, and a few other gifts. So really trying to kind of bring that last personal touch to that send off. And finally, I just want to say thank you to our community. We know that distance learning is not probably perfect. It does not fit everybody well. I know that our staff and our administration have gone to great lengths to figure out how to best support each learner in a distance learning environment and have made adjustments along the way. But I just want to say thank you to our community and just my appreciation for the grace and flexibility that everybody has had throughout this process. We've worked very diligent to make this as successful as possible. And knowing that we don't know what the fall is going to look like, we will take lessons learned from the last 2 months and apply those to however we're organized for school next year. So with that being said, Whatever comes our way, whatever the Minnesota Department of Education tells us we need to do in terms of organization, you can trust that we got this because we are 192. Have a great summer, everybody. Enjoy time with your family, and hopefully we can see everybody face to face next fall.